Nabanggit kasi ni Senator Ontiveros doon sa de-escalation of tensions at nabanggit rin ni Secretary Manalo, isn't it advisable that we stick to the old routine of using civilian units such as the Coast Guard to conduct the RORE and
the Coast Guard man has never been used to conduct RORES.
So RORE has always been military. You're saying this as far as
the,
when?
We can discuss it, ma'am, in but it has been since the start. It has been
the start that's President
several
Aquino.
Years ago. Yes, ma'am.
From President Aquino?
Yes, I believe so. Yes.
Okay. Okay. There's been a suggestion to use helicopters, and then there were different opinions na yung helicopter mas
we can
mabulo.
Discuss
may
it.
Helipad kasi yung BRP magbanwa, di ba?
Ma'am, we can discuss it later.
Okay, but that was one of the possibilities. And
there's
then,
several options that have
that's
been
an option, but to take off from Magbanwa and then rappel down to Sierra Madre.
All those options, ma'am, are viable options. That
other viable.
And we leave it to the Admiral Torres, being the
Shepherd.
WESCOM commander, to decide what the appropriateness.
Sure,
of.
But they're all being studied, I understand. Is that correct?
Yes,
ma'am. Kasi ang daming haka-haka sa media. Gusto lang namin na na aalagaan at nababantayan na pagtatanggol natin ang ating mga sundalo kung may mas safe ika nga na walang masyadong mapanganib at walang madali, mas okay sana, no?
Opo, ma'am. Naturally, ma'am, in accordance with the statement of the President, the welfare of the soldiers and the safety are paramount. Let me also digress to the question of Senator Ontiveros, if I may be permitted. President has said we're not in the business of instigating wars. Nonetheless, we have to really be conscious of our obligations under Article 1 of the Constitution that our territorial integrity and sovereignty are not compromised. And we're playing a very, very delicate balance here between not compromising our sovereignty and sovereign rights through acquiescence or any form of permission seeking or countenancing by another party, with balancing the safety of our people and the risk of a miscalculation. Therefore, the rules of engagement have been very strict, and I join our country in praising the restraint and professionalism shown by our troops, because one shot in anger could have ignited something which, fortunately, because of the superior training and discipline of the troops, was not done, did not happen. Nonetheless, our mandate really is to ensure that none of our sovereign rights and our sovereignty and territorial integrity are compromised. And I think the troops are very, very, they're very adamant in performing this mission with as much professionalism as they can. So in addition to the de-escalation that the DFA is mandated to do, on the other hand, we have a mandate to continue with our resilience and our building up of a credible deterrent force at the soonest possible time. Because that is the only way we can sustain a credible and fair diplomatic negotiated settlement without violating our constitution. Thank you, Madam.
Thanks very much.